Hi, I'm Sean O'Sullivan. Welcome to another episode of Smash 1 Paintball. I'm joined by Tey-na here today. We're going to talk about a couple teams that she owns and a little bit about things that she's interested in, so on and so forth, and, you know, what vegetable she would want to be, right? Well, welcome to the show, first off. Thank you very much.
I appreciate it.
Just tell us a little bit about yourself.
As far as how I got into paintball?
Yeah, how did you get into paintball?
It started with my husband flying an owner of a private jet. He had a paintball team, so he got involved in it, got my son involved into paintball, and just the action, the passion, the excitement grew from there. There was an opportunity to buy a franchise, and I thought, what a great way to offer guys out here a spot to play.
So you own both an MXL and a CXL franchise?
That's correct.
Which franchises do you own?
This is my second year MXL, it's Cardiff Epic, and first year for Exile, and it goes under the name St. Albert Exile.
St. Albert Exile.
This will be our first year.
What were some of the initial challenges when you first purchased the MXL franchise last year?
One of the biggest challenges was getting players out to try out. Yep. Nobody knew who we were, so we didn't have a credibility behind us. So it took a lot of work to have players come out, then choose the right players. We were fortunate and got a very good group of guys that played last year and stuck with us this year.
So a lot of them did stick with you this year?
Yes.
Yeah. After your season last year, which was a very successful season, is there anything that you would do differently going into this new season with the MXL franchise?
No, I'm really happy with how the season went last year. The players went out and played their game. They played the point. They know what they're doing. I'm not the one on the field, and I trust them, and they know what they're working on. I don't think I'd change a thing with my guys.
Was there any one particular player or any multiple players out there that really, really stood out for you? That really, had that team, the team building thing on?
All of the guys were like that. We actually became a family, not just at the field, but off the field. A couple of our players have gone up to CXBL now. I'm very proud of all of them.
Okay, so, and this year now you've purchased, obviously we just talked about the CXBL franchise.
Correct.
What are the differences between owning an MXL franchise and a CXBL franchise?
I would say that there's a different level of commitment. The passion that the players have at CXBL is the same as an MXL level, but they're playing a higher quality. There's probably more vested in it. I would say that the practice schedule is enhanced, and there's always that desire to get out to Richmond Cup, so these guys are financially vested not only in the team, but knowing that, hey, we're working to something big at the end. Mm-hmm. Great guys.
So, on to just general X-Ball news, the AXBL recently just shut the doors, right?
Correct.
How is that going to affect the CXBL? Are we going to see more, less? Are we going to get the same? What's your opinion on that?
My opinion is I don't think we're going to see a lot out west impacting us. The Central and the Eastern, players that are handy are probably going to cross the border and play for the Canadian teams. It's going to bring our level up and increase our player pool to draw from.
And RXL, you think it's going to happen in the west?
I want to make it happen.
Yeah?
I'll be the first to purchase an RXL franchise. I'm really going to bat to bring that lower level in. Mm-hmm. Our MXL is at a high level, and I'd like to have an opportunity for 5, 6, 7 more teams to start out and grow the players through the divisions.
Excellent. Well, thank you very much for coming out. We're out of time. Hopefully we can sit down with you at some other point and chat longer.
I look forward to it.
But thank you very much for coming out, and best of luck this year with both franchises. Maybe we'll see you purchase an RXL franchise.
I'm looking forward to it. Thank you very much.
Right. Stay tuned for more episodes on Smash 1 Paintball. Thank you very much.
And any man who knows a thing knows he knows not a damn thing at all. And every time I felt the hurt and I felt the giving getting me up off the wall, I'm just gonna take a minute and let it ride. I'm just gonna take a minute and let it breeze. I'm just gonna take a minute and let it ride. I'm just gonna take a minute and let it breeze.
How did Mandela get the will to surpass the everyday when injustice had him caged and trapped in every way? How did Gandhi ever withstand the hunger strikes and all? Didn't do it to gain power or money, if I recall, as the gift. I guess I'll pass it on. Mother thinks it'll lift the stress of Babylon. Mother knows. My mother, she suffered blows. I don't know how we survived such violent episodes. I was so worried. It hurt to see you bleed. But as soon as you came out the hospital, you gave me sweets. Yeah. They tried to take you from me. But you still only gave them some prayers and sympathy. Dear mama, you helped me
by showing me to give is priceless. And any man who knows a thing knows he knows not a damn, damn thing at all. And every time I felt a hurt and I felt a giving getting me up off the wall. I'm just gonna take a minute and let it ride. I'm just gonna take a minute and let it breeze. I'm just gonna take a minute and let it ride. I'm just gonna take a minute and let it breathe. All I can say is the worst is over now. We can serve the hard times, divorce, it's over now. They try to keep us out, but they doors is open now. Acorn is getting awards and covers now. This is Tey-na and still repping the S. Coming out of Mogadishu and still draped in the mess. And no matter how we strong, homie, it ain't easy coming out of where we from, homie. And it's the reason why I can never play for me. Tell them the truth is what my dead homies told me. Ooh yeah, I take inspiration from the most heinous of situations, creating medication out my own tribulations. Dear Africa, you helped me write this by showing me to give is priceless. And any man who knows a thing knows he knows not a damn, damn thing at all. And every time I felt a hurt and I felt a giving getting me up off the wall. I'm just gonna take a minute and let it ride. I'm just gonna take a minute and let it breeze. I'm just gonna take a minute and let it ride. I'm just gonna take a minute and let it breeze.
Very much.
Loud enough?
Blah, blah, blah.